Instead of sending her to hell. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare. Then a whirlwind demon came, and he kicked up dust and stones. Where's Krishna? Dried your shoulder, fell down with hideous groans. The demon carried baby Krishna high into the sky, but Krishna forced him down the way, he broke his bones and died. When Yashoda picked him up, then she pacified her mind. She thanked the Lord above for being so merciful and kind. She chanted names of God to protect the child from harm. She didn't know that the Lord was smiling in her arms. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Right now, we are in a place named Bankanti Mahadev. Mahadev means Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva, here in Vrindavan, is living in form of Gopeshwar Mahadev. We already know it. He wanted to enter into Ras. He got little mercy of Yogamaya and she made him Gopeshwar. Gopeshwar means Ishwar, whose gopis are Ishwar, a lady form. But
Mike
nahi aaj.
That temple is Mike, you didn't leave. Then, Sanatan Goswami was staying in Madan Mohanji, a nearby temple. And he was very much friendly with Gopeshwar Mahadev, always going from his place to Gopeshwar Mahadev, Delhi. When he became old, then Lord Shiva said, oh, you have become so old, you have to come all the way to see me. I am very much unhappy because of this. Don't worry. I will come nearer to you so that you need not to cover such a long distance. So, Gopeshwar Mahadev from that place came here. It is quite nearby to Madan Mohanji temple where Sanatan Goswami was staying. Therefore, Bankanti Mahadev is the same Gopeshwar Mahadev, just from that place he has come here also. That's all. God Premanande.
Jaldi jaldi.
Our most revered and
Lord, dearest Lord, pioneer of Rupanuga Math. Srila Rupa Goswami, when he came here, he was instructed by the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that you have to reveal and manifest deities in Vrindavan, different deities in Vrindavan. And then, he was very much concerned for it. When he came here, he found it was a dense forest. There was no trace of any temple here at all. He used to go on moving from here to there in search of established vigra if he could find, in search of some pastimes if he could find. This movement is called in fact parikrama. Maharaj explains the meaning of parikrama, that when we step forward in search of pastimes of Krishna, in search of those places where in such pastimes have been performed, then such movement is called parikrama. He was quite sad because he was unable to find anything. Then once a Brahmin came with him when he was doing that parikrama. Or we may say, Govinda himself came to him in form of Brahman. Oh Baba, you look like so modest, so sad. What's the reason? He said, my Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has endowed a job to me that I should find out vigraha, and so far I have not found any vigraha in Vrindavan. I don't know how to do it also, and I am not getting any way out for it. Very simple. Brahma says, very simple. I give you one way out. Yes, I belong to this place, I can tell you. Look, there is a small hill, mole hill, that is called Goma Tila. Goma Tila. Tila means? It's small hill. It is less than hill. It is by collecting of lot of stones and dust, when it becomes a little higher thing, it becomes tila. So, Goma means of a cow. You go to Goma Tila. At mid morning, 12 p.m., you will find, it will be 12 p.m. At 12 p.m., you will find a cow comes there and milk automatically comes out of her udder. And where that milk falls, you will find out something. Go and find out something. And at that time he went there and he dug it that place. He saw cow came here and milk automatically starts dropping in form of milk stream, bar. And he dug that place, excavated, and Govindaji was there. In fact, this is the deity established by Badrinath, grandson of Krishna. And because of Yamuna, Pujari put it under a rock or under some earth. And then Rupa Goswami manifested, revealed it. So this temple was found like this. Prabhuji was telling, Govind Dev Ji is predominating deity of Abhideya Tattva. We should understand what does it mean. Earlier we went to Madan Mohan Temple. That temple is established by Sri Sanatana Goswami, and that deity is predominating deity of Sambandha Tattva. First we realize our relationship with God. Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead and we are His eternal servant. This is the basic relationship. But with the help of Guru and Vaishnava, the dense relationship with Krishna in Braj is starts revealing. And when we start realizing our relationship with Krishna, the natural second step is that we feel like to serve Him. And that is called bhakti and bhajan and abhidhan. When we feel like to serve Him, and a deity which really teaches us to serve is called Govinda. Govinda with Radha Rani in Vrindavan is there, and we should serve them with our Nama Mantra, mantra given by our Gurudev. This mantra enables us that we should do Archana of Radha Govindev Vigraha. Thinking that they are in Vrindavan with, along with their other associates, Parikas, Radha Govindev is standing, Govindev is smiling, and we are doing Archana, not we are doing. Our Gurudev is one of the Parikas of Radha Govindev, is doing Archana, and we are supplying paraphernalia to him. And this way we are adding ourselves, attaching ourselves to that worshipping. This way when we will do worshipping by our Guru Mantra, gradually our heart will clean and our relationship with Krishna will be revealed and our pastimes will start revealing in us and then we will start doing bhajan along with those pastimes that is called Saurashti Puja. There are two types of worshipping, Prabhupada told. One is Mantra Upasana, Maharaj also said, Mantra Upasana, and second is Sarasaki. Sarasaki means, Swar means your own. Rath means in the mellow you are attached. The permanent Rath, the Thai Bhav which we have, with, when we start worshipping Lord with that, Krishna with that Rath, then it is Sarasaki. So Govindev is so attractive that in our bhajan with Sri Krishna Das Prabhu's son, written by Sri Bhaktivinoda Thakur, which is nothing but explanation of a shloka of Rupa Goswamiji himself written, that if you want to enjoy with your family members, please don't go to Kesi Garden Mathura. Thereby Kesi Garden, there is a temple of Govindev Ji and Govindev Vigraha is present there. So don't go to Kesi Ghat, because if you will go to Kesi Ghat, it may be possible that you may come to that temple and see Govindev Ji. And if you will see Govindev Ji playing your flute and seeing you at his slight glance, you will be totally finished. And you will never be able to enjoy with your family members. At all attachment with your family members you have got, don't go there. So, he is giving option to us, try either be, remain in enjoying mode with your family member or give it. So, Govind Devi is so much attractive. Only because of this reason, when he is so much attractive and when we do that puja will enable us to establish ourselves in our real life. So, we should pray here. One thing was that this deity was taken away by King of Jaipur Mansingh. Aurangzeb was envious of this temple. This temple was very opulent temple of Vrindavan at that time. It was so high that the light being lamp, the lamp, light of the lamp of this temple used to go up Delhi, that fort where King Aurangzeb was staying. And once he came to know that it is Vrindavan temple, he was envious of temple and even the temple of Raja Man Singh, he was more envious. He wanted to show to somehow or other pull down King Raja Man Singh. He had some ill feelings for Raja Man Singh because Shivaji was arrested by Aurangzeb and he was a very great enemy of Aurangzeb. But because of Man Singh's trick, Shivaji could escape from the arrest of, from the jail of Aurangzeb. So he wanted to give a lesson to Man Singh, King Man Singh. So he invaded Vrindavan and he tried to destroy all those temples which belonged to Man Singh. But Raja Man Singh came to know. So Gopinath, Govindeji and Madan Mohan, and Damodar, Raja Damodar, Jamsundar, these all
Raja Ramon,
so here is a replica of that both ritis. We should go our head to it. Raja Govindeji is so far we have there in Jaipur. And right now it is predominating deity of Jaipur. Jaipur's heart. Throbbing heart of Jaipur is Raja Govindeji. So Maharaji once told me that because Govindeji found here were not good devotees, and some good devotees were present in Jaipur, so Radha Govindeji arranged himself to go there. The real temple is the old temple nearby. Every huge building, and he was telling this building was multi times more huge than this. Aurangzeb came and destroyed this building and took the red stone to Mathura and constructed a mosque over there that is called Jama Masjid in Mathura. And that also had the birthplace of Lord
Krishna.
It was 70 stories, now 4 stories he had abolished, only 3 stories remain. When we will go, we will see.
दरवाजे पर भगवान की
This is the place where Mahadev to take bath.
What happened?
To take deep hair, and he became she. Mahadev became she. Mahadev was very much keen to see Ras Leela. Then he prayed to Yogmaya, Puranmashi. I want to see Ras Leela. Please show me Ras Leela. She said, you can't see Ras Leela in this man form. You have to become gopi. Do anything what you want to do, but let me see Ras Leela. Then Puranmashi asked him to take a dip here in Brahmkund. And he took a dip and he became a very beautiful lady, Gopeshwar. Its name became Gopeshwar. So then Yogmaya, Puranmashi asked him to sit here and see Ras. Now when Ras was being performed, they were unable to have real charm of Ras. Krishna said, Sam, Vijatiya. Vijatiya means? Unlike-minded personality. Like-minded and unlike-minded.
Different
caste. So unlike-minded some personality is there, find it out. Then gopis, they found that, well, this gopi is new. They went to her. What is your name?
He said, my name is Mahadev, Shivji.
If I tell them Shivji, the whole secrecy will be revealed. He kept quiet. Then said, what is name of your village? He thought, Puranmashi did not told me. Then I have to tell the name of village also. Who is your husband? He said, me and husband? Are you myself husband? How can I have a husband? And when they were keep on asking such questions, your name, your village name, your in-laws village, your parental village, your sister-in-law and all, he could not reply. He was thinking that Puranmashi did not train me for these things, that I had to answer like this. Then they said, look, she is the unlike-minded. She has come here, and they started beating, giving punch on her cheeks, not his cheeks, on her cheeks. And he started crying, oh, Yogmaya, Puranmashi, save me, Puranmashi, save me. Then Puranmashi came running. Oh, please don't beat. Then Krishna also came. Krishna said, what happened, Puranmashi? She said that, look, he is Mahadev. He wanted to see your Ras Leela. Then Krishna said, look, Shivji is my very innermost devotee. And he wanted to see Leela. Gopis, please allow him to do so. Then they allowed him. They said, okay, you can't participate in Leela, but you can see a certain corner, Ishan Kon. Ishan Kon is one corner of Bansi Bhatt. He was situated over there, and from there he saw all the Ras Leelas. So let us pray here. This is undeveloped. Many kunds have been developed, but this kund is not developed. It escaped from the sight of some Brijvasis. So we have to see through our X-ray sight, penetrating sight. Brahm kund means, he was saying that probably Krishna showed his Brahman roop in his mouth also once upon a time. So its name is Brahmkund also here. We should not confuse between two. This is Brahmkund and there is Brahmharad, near Akroor Ghat. And when Akroor was going to Mathura, he took bath over there. That is called Brahmharad, not Kund. That is the part of Yamuna. So now,
abhi kahan chalna hai bhai? Aaiye babu, aaiye.
Oh, Premananda.